the spiritual prison. But on this day I've arisen to the vision of an internal God and Satan collision. The fight to win me took place within me, and whoever I submitted to would ultimately choose when it was in me. I feel motionless, approaching this comatoseness with openness. Could only hope and wish for sanity when I awoke from this. I'm coping with the possibility of making the wrong choice. No reason to rejoice. I heard Satan speaking my own voice. Love me, don't you? Everything I've been to you since day one. Remember all the happiness I sent to you. The days that I provided ways for cash to pay the rent for you. The things you meant to do that he prepared you. I lent to you. He tested you and you let worldly elements affect you. The things that I prevented you were done so to protect you. I expect you to make mistakes, but call, I won't neglect you. Follow me and I'll eject secular ways and resurrect you. You know I'll follow you, God. Your power, I done seen it. Yeah, I hear your mouth profess, but I don't think you really mean it. You've been claiming religion, but you seem to do what I say. If he got more to offer, why you always leading my way? That's a good question. See, God, it's like you there, but still a one deep. Sometimes the abstract's harder to take to than the concrete. So talking faith is one thing. I want to feel you like a sunbeam. But a key part of faith, son, is believing in the unseen. What do you mean? Let me explain it, K-Reno. Do you believe you have a brain? Yeah. Have you ever seen it? No. Oh, now do you understand? Yeah, it just hit me. Just because I can't see you, that don't mean that you ain't with me. Let me jump between this nonsense. Y'all analyze too much. What feels better, things you visualize, a thing that you can touch. You already know the business. If you step into my zone, I'll award you all the best for things that you'll never control. This reminds me of a Dolomite movie. If I make a deal with you, then in the end, you gon' do me. I'm caught between two forces trying to actively pursue me. Confused on who's truly loaded with the tools to rule me.
Yes, indeed. Chosen Elect family, how many of you feel like you're caught between two opinions? Like you have the enemy on one side and the Most High Yah on the other, and you're caught up in the Valley of Decisions. That was the Valley of Decisions by none other than K-Reno. And if you can relate to the lyrics in that song, that means you are back yet again on another journey to truth in life, where we utilize this power of truth to be set free from the chains of deception. And in this particular video, we're going to be closing out infiltration with the most controversial hot button topic with regarding infiltrators, and that's the honeypot. In the previous live stream, we gave the acronym as to what honeypot stand for: human observation network espionaging you. And then of course the P.O.T. stands for piece of trash, because these people who participate in such deeds are nothing more than a piece of trash. They are truly lowlifes. But as the scriptures tell us in the book of Corinthians chapter 2 around verse 11, we should not be ignorant of Satan's devices. The book of 1 Peter, I believe 5 around verse 8-ish, says we must be sober-minded because our enemy, our adversary, which is these devils in human synthetic skin flesh — the devil's not a Morpheus, elusive blob of whatever causing mischief. These devils look like us, they're walking among us, they're working with us, they're churching with us, and sometimes they're even sleeping with us. And this is where the honeypot comes in. But we got to be sober-minded, as 1 Peter 5 and 8 says, because our adversaries, these infiltrators, these gang stalkers, these provocateurs and these honeypots and much, much more, these handlers, they're walking around seeking whom they can destroy, whom they can devour. And one way that they do that is the infiltration process. Now, we know that the enemy, when the kingdom of darkness has it out for a chosen elect, they go through five stages before they can eliminate chosen elect. The first one is O2, observation obsession. They will watch you. They will hack your phones. They will hack your cable. They will send spies out. They will hack your internet services. They will track, trace, monitor you. They will become obsessed with watching you. And it's in their nature because their fathers, which is these fallen angels, we won't get into the book of Enoch today, nor the book of Daniel, which describes these celestial beings, which are going to present themselves as aliens, but they're celestial beings is what they are, which fell from grace due to their disobedience. They slept with the daughter of the human, and they bore offspring. Their offsprings are known as the workers of iniquities, tares that are living among us. They're the ones who never was destined to be walking on this earth. And they'll send them after you. They send them definitely after your boy MTAC. And one of the ways that you know you're chosen is if you're being obsessively watched and observed, and that's part one. But what are they watching you for? So that they can commence part two. What is part two? That's the series that we're in right now, and that is infiltration, right? And of course, after infiltration, you have manipulation, deception. This is where all the deceit, the Truman shows, the fake realities, a whole lot of manipulation begins to come into play, right? And we live in the era of deep fake and fake news. So you can't believe nothing you hear, and only 25%, I'll say, of what you see, because we live in the age of technology, deception, right? Project Bluebeam, etc. Artificial intelligence, sentient deep learning programs capable of cinematography, right? And much, much more. After manipulation, step four, intimidation. The enemy wants you to come out of faith into fear. And the way he does that is through the intimidation, making you feel like your life is in danger, making you feel like no one is for you. But I remind you of the scripture, the Father never leaves us, nor does he forsake us. Abba Yah is with us, even until the end of this world and beyond, right? And after, if he's able to get you out of faith into fear, you know what I mean? If he's able to get you out of faith, when you lose your love, it says perfect love casts out all fear. And so if you love the Father and you love your neighbor as yourself, you're keeping that golden rule that he can't get you out of faith into fear. You know, so once we keep the greatest commandments, which is love, then we remain in faith. And I'm hoping for you what should I refer to you as? Advanced scripture believers of truth, you understand what I'm talking about. The scripture says perfect love cast out all fear. And the way that we stay in the faith and out of fear is by loving the Most High so much that it don't matter if it cost our life. Loving our neighbors so much that it don't matter if people talk about us behind our back or whatever the case may be. We won't do harm to our neighbor. We want for them what we want for ourselves, and we want to obey the Father and reference and honor him more than anything. And there's nothing that can detour us from that, even if it's our own harm. And if he can intimidate you, which is number four, he will dominate you. That's number five. So the enemy wants to have dominion, which the Most High gave us the dominion, his offspring dominion over this realm. We supposed to have been at it. Why did we lose dominion? You got to go back to the book of Genesis, starting around chapters 2 and 3. And you'll see that because of sin, we lost our connection with our power. Elohim of heaven and earth. El means power. And so when you lose your power, when you lose the Holy Spirit, the Ruach Kadosh, then you lose sense of who you are. And you become like that movie. It's an old cartoon movie called Lion King. Simba, when he got disconnected from his father and his heritage, he lost sense of who he was and he lost his power. And next thing you know, if you ever watch that little cartoon movie, he thought he was a furry rat or pig, and he was eating little bugs, they call them grubs, out of logs, and he was swinging on vines singing Kumbaya until, you know, somebody, a monkey cracked him over the head and said, look at who you are. Look into your reflection and see the Father in you. And when he recognized who he was, he went back and, you know, took back everything that the enemy had stole from him, which was his royalty. And this is what we're here for, to journey back to what is rightfully ours. But we're talking about infiltration today, the honeypot infiltration, and hopefully as the Holy Ruach leads you, my testimony and what the Most High shares through me, because I'm just a vessel, I'm just a tool he used to do his handiwork, right? There's nothing special about me, other than the fact that he decides to use this crooked stick every now and again to draw straight lines for the people. And so I'm just happy to be of service in his kingdom building. But honeypots, human observation network espionaging you. Pieces of trash, that's all they are. And for those of you who don't know what espionage is, this is just a standard definition, E-S-P-I-O-N-A-G-E. Espionage is a person who commits spying or acts of spying, any individual or spy ring in a service of a government. So they can be working for the feds, or CIA, FBI, NSA, DHS. There's a whole lot of those demonic alphabet groups nowadays. A company such as, I worked for, you know, Schneider Demonic Intermodal in Chicago, and they were definitely a cult ring full of some weirdos. But I digress. A criminal organization. So they're all criminals, right? They're all criminals. But it could be a criminal organization or a secret society such as the Masonic Order, or independent operations such as PI firms. That's real big nowadays, right? They used to have like bounty hunters back in the 80s and the 90s before this technology blew up, and FISA, the Foreign Intelligence Surveillance Act, added the Section 702, which made it seemingly legal, which it's not, for foreign intelligence and militant groups, the industrial military complex, to treat American citizens the same way they do foreigners that aren't entitled to constitutional protection. So 702 is definitely unconstitutional, illegal, and they shouldn't be treating so-called American citizens like foreign threats to begin with. But I digress again because we can snowball off topic. But continuing, so a person who commits espionage is an agent or spy. Any individual in a service of a government, company, criminal organization, or independent operation. And that can be, you know, we talked about that, can commit espionage. The practice of a clandestine, so clandestine is secretive operation being carried out against you, right? That means you don't know it's black operation. For those of you who have military or law enforcement background, you know what the word clandestine mean. And I don't have to define it for you. But for those of you who don't know what clandestine mean, it's C-L-A-N-D-E-S-T-I-N-E. You can go look that word up for yourself. Study to show yourself approved. I can't do all the work for you. As it is, by definition, unwelcoming. So this is something that we didn't ask for. If you're a targeted individual, chosen elect individual, no, none of us asked for this, and none of us want this. In some circumstances, it may be a legit tool of law enforcement. In others, it may be an illegal act punishable by law. Now, if you're being gang stalked and your Fifth and Sixth Amendment isn't being invoked, which means you have the right to know what you're being accused of, who your accusers are, and you have the right to confront them in a court of law, a due process, and you have the right to jury by trial, a speedy trial, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. If it's not leading to that, and it's just people following you around to torment you, to torture you, and to make your life a living hell, this is illegal. But beyond that, on a spiritual side, it's pretty much satanic. As a matter of fact, it's totally satanic. Evil, wicked, etc. But these workers of iniquities, which are doomed for destruction, that's all they know. They're of their fathers, which are these fallen angel devils, and the works of their demonic fallen angel fathers is what they're going to do. So just like Azazel in the movie Fallen, that they just do it in the flesh form. They don't have to jump from body to body like Agent Smith. They are the bodies which the spirits of their demonic fathers jump in and out of in order to torment and espionage the righteous. And there's more to the definition, but for time's sake, I will digress. You can go look it up for yourself. But that's what they're doing. They're spying on you. They're carrying out clandestine works for a hidden hand, and that hidden hand could be secret societies, could be cults, could be government organizations such as the FBI and its COINTELPRO operations, or the CIA and their Operation Chaos, MKUltra, etc. It could be the NSA and DIA, who's heavily involved in Barack Obama's Brain Initiative project, where they are indeed you know, using this so-called spiritual technology in order to hack the consciousness of the human being, brain hacking, right? So now we live in the era of Elon Musk and Neuralink with the technology that is capable of wirelessly picking up the electrical signals of the neurons or the brain cells and interpreting that to attempt for this Antichrist beast system to emulate the power of the Most High. Only the Holy Spirit, only the Word, and I forget what scripture, I even forgot the book. I want to say it's in the book of Hebrews. As a matter of fact, I'm almost certain it's in the book of Hebrews. It says, the Word of the Most High, the Spirit of the Most High is sharper than any two-edged sword, discerning the thoughts, minds, intentions of the hearts and minds of men, right? The thoughts. So only the Word, only Yeshua, only the Holy Spirit, only the Most High Yah can understand what a person is thinking. But they want to emulate that with this artificial intelligence technology, etc. And they've been doing this for a long time, people. This is nothing new. It goes all the way back past the Cold War. It goes, Adolf Hitler was doing this in the 1930s. His demonic fallen angel his scientists and psychologists and sociologists was working hand in hand with the fallen angels. They gave the Germans technology to build hovercrafts. We would call them UFOs or whatever the case may be, but they had that technology. They also had, you can go back as far as Nick Tesla and him attempting to build time machine travels and the looking glass and attempting to manipulate physical science in order to empower man with godlike powers, which was, you know, I'm not going to get into that. If you haven't studied Nick Tesla and Adolf Hitler and the German experiments of MK Ultra Monarch, then it would be a fine time to do so, because we live in that age where if you're ignorant of Satan's devices, if you haven't learned or you don't know history, you're going to repeat it and reap the repercussions thereof. And during the Cold War, the CIA, we know what they were doing, right, with their LSD and MK Ultra experiments, and women was their prime target. I can't think of the name of the women mental and psychological institute in Canada that the CIA took their stolen funds and carried out all these mind control experiments. If you know the name of that hospital, put it in the chat. Kabosh is back on saying shalom, fam. Shalom, shalom, shalom. And welcome on. I definitely am blessed to have all of your presence here. Your time, your attention is just so amazing. You know what I mean? But if you know the name of that all women's mental institute that the CIA went into Canada, which was outside of, you know, jurisdictional bounds, and carried out those crazy experiments, then put it in the chat so that people can research it and know your boy MT knows what he's talking about. They also was kidnapping unprotected women from the communities, specifically from the urban communities, and carrying out these MK Ultra experiments and LSD experiments with women with no husband, women who seem to be ladies of the night, women without protection, without money. They were kidnapping them, bringing them into their lairs, turning them into sleeper cell agents, basically, and then releasing them to the public as their espionage tools, right? So these women who were captured by the CIA, they were placed into electric shock mind control programs, like a Manchurian Candidate. It was the female version of the Manchurian Candidate project, which is sick and satanic, because that's the only way to describe it. It's just evil in its core, but this is the truth. And this was during the, you know, Cold War era in the 60s or whatever the case may be, and even in all the way up to the 70s, throughout the 70s, and they're still doing it to this day. It never stopped. You know, you don't stop when you get a spanking on your wrist. Somebody got to spank that tail. My mama used to tear that tail up. So you knew when she said, don't do that no more. Hey, you felt the pain and you remembered that and you didn't do it. But only thing that this satanic Luciferian government does to the CIA and the FBI is give them a slap on the wrist, you know, and they continue to do it more secretive and more provocative than they ever had done it before. They become more crafty, as Satan, that's his nature, right? He's, these serpents are crafty. Read the book of Genesis chapter 3, verse 1. And so they would kidnap these women and they would put them through these mind control programs after they were already debased on life. And whatever Manchurian project that hypnotized them, they were then released back out, and they've been doing this for many, many years out into population. And you thinking that's a normal woman, you know, but she's a Manchurian candidate, a honeypot, a human observation network espionaging you agent, right? I don't even want to call them pieces of trash because they're victims as well, but you know, the things that they do classify them as pieces of trash. And so I've ran into honeypots when I first started getting gang stalked, and you've probably ran into honeypots too, because the enemy, other part of the definition, right, of espionage, is it says espionage is often part of an institutional effort by the government or commercial businesses. However, the term tends to be associated with the state spying or potentially or actual enemies for militant purposes. Or military purposes. Spying involves corporations, is called industrial espionage, right? And it goes on to say spies main purpose is to gather intel, information about how to destroy you or throw you off, how to neutralize a person, right? And this is the assignment of the honeypot. If you've had a honeypot agent in your life, it's because the system, the so-called powers that be, sees you as a threat to their continual establishment and stability, right? So if your light shining in this dark world, the kingdom of darkness knows that your light, your righteousness, your intentions to do the right thing and to expose evil threatens their very existence. And you can read the book of John, chapter 3, verses 17 through 21, because it talks about how these workers of iniquities, these dark people, these occultists, basically, don't like people with the light. They hate the light because their deeds are evil. And the book of Ephesians, chapter 5, verses 10, 11 says, for it is a shame to even speak of the things that they do. This is why come they need secret societies and non-disclosure agreements and gag orders and, you know, black ops, whatever the case may be, because it's a shame to speak of the things that they do in secrecy, because it's so evil, so wicked, so sinister and volatile that it would make a normal person sick to the stomach. You know, you're talking about Hannibal Lecter with the FBI badge. You're talking about, let's think of another psychopath. What's the guy named Lex Luthor from Superman with the CIA or FBI badge or NSA badge? You know, extremely knowledgeable of a lot of things, educated in a lot of areas, but unwise, very wicked, very unstable, and extremely chaotic. This is what we're dealing with. You take that and you put, you give that type of unstable mind the power over a female, especially, you know, and I'm pretty sure for you women out there that they have men honeypots as well. MK Ultra men honeypots out there to throw your life off, to bring chaos in, to gather intel and to disrupt your progress, to keep you from the blessings that the Most High have for you. They're espionaging you ladies as well. You better believe it. And they'll send honeypots your way. And they know exactly what you like. Why? Because part one, what stage one of the enemy's attack, you know what it is. The enemy have watched and observed, and he knows, you know, what you like. If you like them tall, he's going to send them tall. If you like them short, he's going to send them short. If you like them skinny, they come skinny. If you like them big bone, they come in big bone. Whatever you like, the enemy has studied, recon, and, you know, and he's ready to take it, step up. Now, that's called counterintelligence. You know, when they always are producing counterproductive measures for any action you take, you know what I mean? To offset that which is in motion. That's what counter means. So they are trying to offset the intelligence which is in motion. So the Most High has given us not the spirit of fear, but power, love, and wisdom, right? And so when we exercise the power, the love, and wisdom, which is the Holy Spirit operating through us, then the spirit of the devils and them are trying to counteract that, create counterproductive measures in order to throw us off. And one way that I can speak as a man that men get thrown off is a beautiful woman. So we're going to go to the scriptures in the book of Judges, and we're going to not read all of it, but for time's sake, we're going to visit how this counterintelligence honeypot operation attempted to destroy a very strong Israelite man of Yah who was predestined to be a savior of his people, to be a deliverer of his people. And welcome on. If you're in the building, shalom, Shabbat shalom. I welcome you on with agape love and open arms. And so I wanted to go here to the scriptures. How many of you don't mind your boy MT going to the scriptures. Sometimes I lose people's attention when I go to the scriptures, but this is a channel, even though I cover many different facets from many different viewpoints and perspectives. I am a man of faith, and my foundation is the word of the Most High Yah. So if you guys don't mind, we're going to go here for our learning. The scriptures were written for our learning, for our reproof, for our edification. And if we don't take the time to glean from them, then they can't help us at all. So we're going to the book of Judges. We're going to start go to 13. We're not going to read every scripture, but we're going to just kind of skim through here. So basically, if you don't know the story of Samson, Samson was born in the time era. He was an elect of the Most High, which means the Most High already knew him before he was in his mother's womb. He was already predestined for a purpose. He had destiny, purpose, and he was empowered. Anytime you have purpose, you're going to have power, protection, and provision in order to fulfill that purpose. So for you chosen elect, remember, the Most High has already given you what you need in order to accomplish your assignment. The problem is many of us don't know what our assignments are. This is why you need to do some soul searching, isolation, and some inter-reflection is very good for that. If you want to know, hey, why am I here? Heavenly Father, why didn't you create me? You know, why is the enemy apt to destroy me? Inner reflection, getting alone, silencing the outside voices so that you can hear the Holy Spirit speaking within you, getting in the Most High's word and allowing him to lead you and draw you to those things. Most of the time, and I don't know why I'm going into this direction, maybe someone needs to hear it, but most of the time your purpose is going to be something that comes extremely natural to you. It's very easy, and it comes so easy that you don't even notice it's there, but other people notice it. So one way that you can identify your purpose is by asking yourself this simple question throughout your life: what is something that everyone else seemed to notice about you or to be drawn to about you that you really don't give that much attention or renown to? That's a place to start, but getting alone, getting in the Most High's word, getting in prayer, inner thoughts is a good way to find out purpose. And with that purpose comes the power to fulfill that purpose, the provision to fulfill that purpose. All right, and we've gotten off subject, so let me get back. I do apologize if I lost anyone. So we're talking about Samson. Samson was an elect of the Most High, and we're just going to read a couple of scriptures so that you guys can read the entirety of it in your own time. So in the book of Judges, chapter 13, how do we know that Samson wasn't an elect? Someone that the Most elect means that you were foreknown of the Heavenly Father, the Most High, before you was in a physical body, before you was in this earth realm. We were already with him. How do you know that you were a soul that was in the Father's heavenly kingdom before you was sent on your assignment to this earth? Or how do we know that Samson was that? All right, so Samson's father name was Manoa, right? And so I don't think it gives his mother's name. But all right, so when the story first starts off, there's a woman who's barren. She can't have children, right? And the nation of Israel is going through constant oppression throughout the book of Judges, starting at chapter 1 up to this point. From what nations? It says you'd be hated by all nations for his namesake. We'll also go through some things for not obeying his law, statutes, and commandments and living a holy, righteous life. So Israel was constantly in and out of the Most High's will. And we got to make sure that we're in the Most High's will if we want that protection and that power, that a promise of blessings for you Israelites. Read Deuteronomy chapter 28. It'll do wonders for you. Talking about the blessings and cursings when we obey his will, when we're in his will, and the cursings when we're out of his will. The blessings come when we apply this righteous living to our life. But throughout the book of Judges, just to give you the backdrop, the antecedent of the story, Israel is constantly being oppressed by their enemies, other nations, being hated, being gangstalked, mostly because when they're blessed, they get comfortable and then they start sinning, doing wrong, doing evil. So the Most High would raise up different nationalities, different descendants of the enemies in order to oppress the children, not to the point of destruction, but to the point of repentance. And that's what this gang stalking for me has probably done the most. It made me run back to the Most High. It made me have a repentant heart and say, hey, Father, what is it that I'm doing wrong? And what do I need to do in order to get right? You know, and this is the position that we need to have. Nonetheless, at this point in chapter 13, there's this barren woman and her husband, Manoah, who's wanting a child, and they're under the heavy oppression of the Philistines, Israel, the nation of Israel. And so, verse 1, it says, and the children of Israel did evil again in the sight of the Most High. And the Most High, it says Lord here, but I like to use the word Most High. The word Lord, you know, is kind of, it's just the way that I read it. So I'm hoping it don't bother you guys. I delivered them unto the hand of the Philistines 40 years. So for 40 years, they were delivered into the hands of the enemy. The same way that it seems like the gang stalking B system is just, we've been given over into their hands, right? At least for a season, for many years, especially since 2012, 2013-ish for me, that's when I noticed it started getting crazy. 2015, it was just out of control, man. These devils was jumping through CERN portals during that phase, and it, I don't want to get off subject, so continuing, verse number 2, and there was a certain man of Zeruah of the family of the Danites. Dan is one of the tribes of Israel. So who was named Manoah, and his wife was barren and bare not. And the angel of the Most High appeared unto the woman and said unto her, behold, now thou art barren and bearest not, but thou shalt conceive and bear a son. Right? So the angel, the Elohim of the Most High, was sent to this woman. Say, you're going to have a son. I already know this. The child hasn't even been born yet. He hasn't even been conceived yet. But I'm the Most High sending someone into your womb. This is why the woman is so blessed, I put it that way, and so special, because she bears and grows the purpose of the Most High in her womb, her blessed womb, right? So her womb was barren. The Most High said, I'm going to use that womb to bring in the deliverer, the savior for this particular time period into this world. Most High already knew he was sending, and he knew, you know, Samson had flaws, etc. And during this assignment, not only was he going to fulfill his purpose in the end, but he was going to perfect himself. And that's what this story is about. But nonetheless, I see I'm losing everyone. It says, I love when you go to the word. Oh, man. Thank you so much, Kabash. I definitely appreciate it. You know, thank you for the support. You'd be surprised how many people hate whenever, you know, I go to the word. They kind of get turned off by the topic. And so I try to only do this during, you know, one-on-ones or whatever the case may be, because the majority of the viewers, some are agents, some are of other faiths, right? I have people on this channel that are atheists. I have some that are of all Scientologists and all sorts of things, but for some reason or another, they get drawn here, and I'm hoping that the Most High, for whatever purpose it is, he use it for his glory. You know, I never question, you know, we're not of the same faith. Why are you here? I just say, hey, I'm here with love, right? And I'm just going to share what the Most High has given me and not and compromise the integrity of my stance, my belief, my faith, etc. So to have someone like you is just amazing. Tragic Magic is in the building saying, what's up? What's good with you, Tragic? You know what I mean? It's been a minute since you've been around, but I definitely appreciate your presence. It just warms my heart to see your support is still with your brother. So thank you so much. I hope all is well. We're talking about the honeypots, the human observation network espionaging you. And for the sake of time, because we're at 48 minutes, let me hurry up and just rush through this. So during this stage, I'll tell you what happens, and then you can go read it for yourself, right? They finally have this son. His name is Samson. And Samson is strong. He's anointed, he's empowered, he's wise. And the enemy knows that his purpose, his assignment, they don't know exactly what it is, but they know it threatens the establishment of their order. You know, the powers that be, they feel threatened when you're someone that the Most High have sent on a special assignment. You know, whether it's like a, you know, Malcolm X, some say, you know, they're for or against MLK, you know what I mean? I like the brother, he's a brother, he's an Israelite, so I support him. You know, Marcus Garvey, anyone, you know, who's on a righteous assignment, right? We could name many. The enemy is going to be out to destroy you, right? So the enemy's like, hey, you know what I mean? This guy's different. They know he's chosen, he's elect, he's different, he don't move, but his downfall was the women. And so when you start in chapter 14, by the time you get here, the first words out of his mouth mentioned in this testimony, is, all right, and it says, and Samson went down to Timnah and saw a woman in Timnah, the daughters of the Philistines, and he came up and told his father and his mother and said, I have seen a woman. That's the first thing he said, I've seen a woman. He didn't know this woman was a honeypot, a gang stalker, right? He just seen this woman, right? And it goes on to say, it says, I have seen a woman in Timnah of the daughter of the Philistines. Now, therefore, get her to wife me. Therefore, get her for me to wife. And so his mother and his father, they talked to him like, hey, man, you know, why do you want to date an enemy's offspring? They're questioning like, hey, are your own people not good enough? Whatever the case may be. And he responds to them by saying, this is verse 3, and it says, Samson said unto his father, get her for me. So he's persistent, for she pleaseth me well. So what do that mean? So this is a rated PG channel. I try to keep it rated PG, rated G for the kids, for the, you know what I mean, whatever the case may be. What do that mean? Hopefully we have adults on. That means she had to broke him off something proper, and the boy was whipped at this point. He had to, you know what I mean? He was thinking with the wrong head. If you get my drift, and she had done put it on. So this honeypot, she put it on him. He couldn't think about nothing else. He didn't realize or put together, this is the enemy. You know what I mean? There's nothing she can do for me. And so the story goes on that he's caught up with this honeypot, and he, still in power, still in protection, provision, and purpose of the Most High. And the enemy sends a line to destroy him, right? But he has so much power, so much strength, he kills the line with his bare hands. Some time passed by. It's only the bones of the line left. And he sees that, hey, the bees have made honey near the spot that I killed this lion a while back. So he takes some of the honey, and then he goes to the enemy. Now they're pretending to be his friend because they haven't quite figured him out yet. They need more intel. This is why the honeypot, the human observation network espionaging him, right, is positioned in his life for the time being. So I'm just giving you a breakdown. Please go read it for yourself. So basically what happens is he makes them a wager. There's a bet. He's being foolish, not mature. And as a chosen elect, you need to be very mature in the way that you move from here on out, because the enemy, as I said in the beginning, is out seeking to devour and destroy whoever's not sober-minded. If you're not stable, how do you be stable? It's simple. As an adult, you should know purpose. Why am I here? If I go to the grocery store, I know my purpose for coming there isn't gossiping with people I haven't seen in a long time. It's not to talk about how to change oil or those nice shoes or whatever. It's to get some groceries. That's why I went there, right? If you go to school, for if there's any students, whether college or high school, know the purpose for going there. It's for education, not to be part of some group or whatever the case may be. But when you lose sense of that, the enemy has the advantage. Corinthians 2, 1 Corinthians want to say 2 and 11, right? So anyway, not being ignorant of Satan's devices, Samson makes this better this way. She said, hey, I'm going to tell you a riddle. You're supposed to be smart. I want you to figure it out. And he pitches this, this little parable to him about the honey. And he, verse 14, and he said unto them, out of the eater came forth meat, and out of the strong came forth sweetness. And they could not in 3 days expound the riddle. They couldn't understand what he was talking about. He was talking about honey out of the lion that he had killed. So what did they do? I'm not going to read it to you for time's sake, but basically they call in the honey pot that was assigned to him and said, hey, we need you to gather some intel on this riddle. And the honeypot agent, she does just that. She makes love to him, get him to talking in bed, that pillow talk. And next thing you know, she have the information. She goes back to her handlers with that information and says, this is what, you know, what this means. And he figures it out, you know. So, and he responds to them later on after, you know, they're like, oh, this is what it means. He's like, there's no way you could have known that, right? Except for this honeypot told you, right? So if you're dealing with a honeypot, don't talk, you know what I mean? Don't be telling, you know, the honeypot your secret. As a matter of fact, you shouldn't be dealing with no honeypots, especially this late in the game of gang stalking. If you're still going through that stage, you're a fool. I'm just being honest. I'm not calling you a fool to put you down or anything. I'm calling you a fool to pull you up out of that mess. Let that honeypot go. As a matter of fact, open the front door, walk them to it, jump 3 feet up in the air, drop kick them in the chest right out of your life and right through the front door. Don't physically do that. I'm saying metaphorically do that. But continuing. So basically, verse 18, it says, and the men of the city said unto him on the seventh day before the sun went down, what the sweeter than honey and the, what is stronger than a lion? And he said unto them, if you had not plowed with my heifer, he called it this honeypot a heifer. He said, man, this lady ain't nothing but a heifer, man. She ain't nothing but a cow, right? A female cow, you know what I mean? Just, and you know what a heifer is. Well, I'm from the country. I'm here in Calhoun, Louisiana. I was born and raised in the country. So cow pastures, man, that's something coming to southern country folks. And every time you see a heifer, every time you see a cow, it's moving its mouth, right? It's regurgitating and chewing on the same thing over and over and over again. You know, if you're dating a heifer, they always bring it up old stuff. And that's what cows do. That's literally what they do. They chew some grass, they swallow it, and then they regurgitate it back into their mouth and they chew it all over again, only to swallow it again, right? So if you chosen elect want to know if you're dating a heifer, a honeypot, and just pay attention. Do they often bring up old mess, starting stuff all, just to complain? You know what I mean? You're like, hey, man, that was something from 2 months ago, last year, whatever the case may be, but they're bringing it up just to have something to talk about, complain about. You may be dating a honeypot, right? So he refers to her as a heifer. He said, hey, look, man, I know you've been working. Plowing means working, right, with the heifer, with the honeypot, in order to have the answer to that riddle and so forth. So he ends up losing this deal and he has to pay a great debt. And the story goes on. I'm not going to spoil the entire story for those of you who have not read the entire story of Samson. Start at Judges chapter 12. I would start at 12 to get the good antecedent and then move through chapter 15. Basically, the enemy sends him one honeypot after the next, and these honeypots ultimately ends up putting him into a position of going into slavery, being in prison, having his eyes put out, which a lot of people, whenever they talk about the story of Samson, they go, well, his special power, his spiritual power was his muscles. He was stronger than any other man. No, that was his protection. You remember when I told you, when you have a purpose, right? When you have a spiritual gifts, whatever, the Most High is going to give you provision. He's going to give you power and he's going to give you protection. Well, his muscles was not his true gift, right? It was his spiritual protection, his physical protection, right? Supernatural strength. What it was, when you read the story, and I'm just going to tell you guys, it was his spiritual vision. He could see, just the same way we read that he could, as soon as they said it, he could see the whole plan. He could see the enemy. He was like, I see in the spiritual realm, you've been talking to this honeypot, this heifer that you done put in my life, or I didn't fail for, whatever, however it went down. He could see it, right? So there's example after example during the testimonies where he's able to, his spiritual vision, he don't even recognize that he has spiritual vision. He's able to see what the enemy is up to, and he ain't even got to be there. He's discerning the minds and the intentions of the enemy, and he's not even knowing that he have that capability. You know, and some of us, we have that capability to be able to discern and know the intentions of people around us, right? And this is one way. Let me read this. It says, yes, it's been a while. It's been a minute. I'm still fighting, man. Glad to see you're still fighting. And never stop fighting for you people. It's going to be ups. It's going to be downs. It's going to be hills and valleys. It's going to be good times. It's going to be times when you just want to throw in the towel, but never, ever stop. The enemy can't stop you. He can only create circumstances that'll cause you to want to give up. You can only stop yourself, right? Because you have the power. And these honeypots, they can't stop you. These handlers can't stop you. The CIA cannot stop you. The FBI cannot stop you. The NSA, Pfizer can't stop you. Nobody can stop you. You know, these devils, there's no devil in hell or walking this earth that can stop what the Most High is for. And this is what you got to know. That takes faith to actually live that. It's one thing to say it, it's another thing to live it. You're talking to, well, you're not talking to, but you're hearing the voice of a man who was stripped all the way down from, I'm not going to say I was living the lifestyle of the rich and famous, because I never was, but I was doing okay for myself. You know, I had decent salary, a stable career, and, you know, stable family and social situation, so I thought. And I was taken all the way down to no friends, families turning their back, being forced into homelessness by the United States government for over 4 years, living in nothing more than a vehicle, from vehicle to every now and again, a motel maybe once a week, taking baths out of a pan. You know, this is my experience. This is my testimony. And we overcome by the words of our testimony. I've been beaten. I've been drugged. I've had things happen to me that will make you throw up by the hands of your United States government. I've been tortured so much I can't even count the times. But nonetheless, I have not given up. Still in a fight, because I understand one thing, that the enemy can't stop me. He can only create situations that will make me want to quit, right? And if I actually quit, then I stop myself. And it's the same for you. I don't know your situations. I'll say most of you, if not all of you, I've never met in person. But I do know that there are universal laws that apply to us all, right? And if you're a light, if you're a good person, the enemy wants you destroyed. He wants you absolutely destroyed. And that's why these devils infiltrate our lives, right? And there's different forms of infiltrators and agent provocateurs. And with the new age technology, they're now doing it more scientifically, technologically advanced, right? And we can get into this into at a different time, maybe the next live stream. We can talk about the new technology that they are commencing as a warfare agent, right? So beyond the community-based harassers or spies living in these safe houses, these FBI, CIA safe houses, pretending to be neighbors, beyond the InfoGuard's corporate expansion into the workplace. If you don't know what InfoGuard is the FBI's private sector. It's workplace agents who work with us, but are also working as eyes, ears, and espionagers for the FBI. It's the FBI's private security sector. So there can be honeypots on the job. It can be honeypots in your communities. It can be honeypots not only that you're dating, but honeypots come in many shapes, forms, and presentation. In this new age, they're not human in more ways than one, because the enemy is sending artificial intelligence. The artificial intelligence agent is probably the most complex yet profound and effective agent that the workers of iniquity have at their disposal in 2023. So you can expect more of artificial intelligence listening in on your phone calls, listening in and tracking your internet searches, and even the cable. This is why there was such a rush to move television services from analog to digital, right? Because the artificial intelligence, deep learning, machine learning, could not operate in the old analog systems. This is why over 20-year time span, telecommunications have advanced from 2G to 3G, which just stands for, second generation to third generation, fourth generation. Now we're all the way up to 5 and 6G. You know, technology. What do that mean? That means now, we're going to have to discuss it in another video. We are over an hour, and so I do apologize, because most of the people who's going to rewatch this video don't want to watch an hour-long video. I do appreciate every last one of you who came out to listen. So hopefully in the next video, we can touch on some of this new age technology and the new unorthodox agent that is out to kill, steal, and destroy the chosen elect, the artificial intelligence, this technology, this science, and bio warfare, etc. Man, it's some deep stuff, and we have a lot to learn. Nonetheless, Scripture says the Holy Spirit is going to teach us, right, this truth. Till next time, you guys, continue to stay woke, continue to stay in the Word, and you will continue to be blessed if you apply it to your life. Your boy, MTAC, Mr. More Than a Conqueror, has got to be his out.